11 News Saturday. We're down in the North Loop at Cooks of Crocus Hill in the cooking area, the cooking school. We have Jeannie Janis here, who is the head of operations, and you have a culinary degree. And we're going to do something we've never done before. We're actually going to be sous-vide turkey breast with a roulade. I'm very confused, but very excited. So yeah. Thank you for doing this.
Oh, it's my pleasure. Well, this is my family's Thanksgiving tradition. So sous vide is an incredible way to make turkey because it's foolproof. You get the perfect turkey every single time. So we like to take it easy on Thanksgiving. This is the best way to make sure that we have the prep done and the perfect turkey every time.
So you have a turkey breast and you also have turkey, the dark meat,
yes.
And you already have it pounded out. And
Thank
so you. Then you roll it into a roulade and then you put it into the sous vide. So as you're rolling it out, tell me about how this works here.
Yeah, so sous vide cooking is in a water bath. And so basically the way that it works is you cook food under pressure in a water bath. And by doing that, you have perfectly controlled temperature that gets you to exactly where you want it to go. So there's no more guessing, is my turkey done? Do I need to cook it a little bit longer? By doing it this way, you know you have it cooked exactly to where it needs to go. So,
and how long would that be for this?
So it's 2 hours. So I brine the turkey overnight. So for 24 hours, we brine the turkey. And then basically just took out the bones. I made stock with all of the bones. And then we roll the turkey into a roulade and we pop it in the sous vide and we cook it for 2 hours.
And you said that after you brine it, you dry it overnight in the fridge so it's really dry.
Exactly, and that's what allows the skin to get crispy. So the best thing about this is you still get the crispy skin that you would get with a roast turkey.
So after 2 hours, it looks like this, so it doesn't really look like it's all browned up, but that's what we're gonna do next.
Yep, so it's not pretty yet, but it will be, so not to worry. So I have it all rolled up. I'm gonna tie off the ends. And then we pop it in the
water bath. So do you do this the morning of Thanksgiving
then? No, I would do this even a day or two before. So this is the kind of prep that you can do way in advance to make your Thanksgiving day
fabulous.
Easier than
ever. And then you put this in the fridge and then just brown it off the day of Thanksgiving.
Exactly.
Okay. So Jeannie, now we move over to the stove. What time in the day do you do this on Thanksgiving?
So this is when we're ready to roll. So all of the prep work is done. I have all of my sides in the oven and I just have to finish the turkey at this point.
And so they're already cooked, so you're just browning them up. And this is the dark meat. And you wanted to mention that if you want to get the dark meat that you can roulade, The Wedge has ones that you can order.
Yeah.
You can buy parts of the turkey.
So they have it in their meat case. And so I bought both the breast and the thigh just from The Wedge. And it's Cadijan turkey, which is a great local farm.
Wonderful. Okay, so then is that just butter in there?
So I started with oil.
Okay.
And that has a lower heat point, and so it allows me to get a really nice sear without burning it. And I'm just gonna finish it with butter. So we're not going to be shy about the butter. We put a good amount in there.
Thanksgiving, man.
Exactly.
Exactly. It's all good to go.
And then
I
added some thyme and garlic. This is what gives it that final flavor. And then we're gonna baste it. So.
Oh yeah.
Just finish getting that beautiful golden brown turkey.
It smells so good.
Yeah. And then as soon as we're done, we pull it out.
Okay.
And then we slice and serve, so we're ready to go.
You don't really have to rest.
Nope.
You could rest, but you don't
you
have
could,
to.
You could, but you don't have to.
Oh, look how beautiful that is. Yeah, it's perfect for a smaller family, perfect for someone that loves all the white meat.
Exactly, you can have the white meat, white and dark meat separate. And if you have a family of four, you don't have a big group getting together and you don't want to do the whole huge turkey, this is the perfect alternative.
Oh my goodness.
So then we just fan it out on our platter.
Oh, it's just gorgeous. I can't wait to dive in. Jeannie, this is such a fun thing. And what's the investment on that?
So the sous vide machine costs $150.
Okay.
Which for the time that you save on Thanksgiving, more than worth it.
It's great for steaks. My brother has one. He swears by it.
Yep.
Well, thank you so much. We're going to share this recipe. And of course, you can get all the recipes for this entire show. It's going to be a ton if you want to text recipes, plural, to 763-797-7215.